students, in previous lecture, we have already discussed about the liberalization. The liberalization means it is a process of removing the controls of the government, and also it is a process of the removing the restrictions of the government on the economic activities. And also we discussed about the important areas where the liberalization measures were introduced in and after 1991, in which we taken the information about the first sector where the liberalization measures introduced, that is the industrial sector. Students, today we are going to take the next sector where the liberalization measures were introduced, that is the financial sector reforms. The financial sector reforms, which includes the financial sector includes the commercial banks, investment banks, stock exchange operation, and the foreign trade market. In our India, the financial sector controlled by the In our India, the financial sector controlled by the RBI is the Reserve Bank of India. Here, all banks are controlled through the various norms and regulations of the RBI. Means here, the all banks are controlled through the different types of the rules and regulations which made by the Reserve Bank of India. Means here, the Reserve Bank of India control the commercial banks via the SLR, means the statutory liquidity ratio. Means it is the minimum proportion, means minimum part of the deposit which maintained by the banks in the form of the liquid. And CAR means it is the obligation of the banks to the commercial banks. And also the RBI controlled the commercial bank via the repo rate as well as the reserve repo rate. Means here the RBI here the Reserve Bank of India fixes the repo rate, reserve repo rate, or maybe the interest rate. Means here these rates which fixed by the RBI, which controls the commercial banks operation, means commercial banks work. And these rates also control the money supply of the commercial bank. Then what is the aim of the RBI? The aim of RBI is Reserve Bank of India from controller to the facility. Why the RBI have to change its role from from the controller to the facilitator. See here, because while the RBI output change its role from controller to the facilitator or from regulator to the facilitator. Because all of you know, RBI used to regulate and control the financial sector that includes the commercial banks, investment banks, stock exchange operation and the foreign trade market. Here, with the economic liberalization and the financial reforms, the Reserve Bank of India, which needed to shift or which needed the financial sector allowed to take decision? Allowed means the financial sector permitted to take the decisions on the many matters which is related to the financial sector without consulting the RBI. That purpose, the RBI wanted to shift or RBI wanted to change its role from the controller to the facilitator. Then, what is the objective behind this? What is the objective behind to change the role of the RBI, means the role of the Reserve Bank of India from controller to the facilitator? The main objective behind this to encourage the private sector participation. Means to encourage the private sector entrepreneurs in economic activity. The second one is to increase the competition among the entrepreneurs. Then next one is to allow it, means to give the permission for the market forces to operate the financial sector. And next one is to give the freedom to set up the new branches. So these all are the objectives behind to change the role of the RBI from controller to the facilitator. So students, this is all about the financial sector reforms. Hope all of you understood this concept.